Hi, I'm Vikas.
Andy.
And we are partners at Brooklyn-based Isometric Studio. I was born in Karachi, Pakistan, and we traveled a lot. And growing up, I was interested in everything. So literature, math, physics, and especially art, because I thought that art was a form of communication that transcends cultures and nationalities and differences. I discovered architecture in undergrad at Princeton, and it was very challenging because there were so many opportunities, and my first year was very hard because I almost felt like I was wasting resources, I was not good enough to be there, and then I discovered architecture, and it was a perfect mixture of everything that I was interested in. It was creative, it was technical, it was process-oriented, and yet it was limitless. And then I knew that I wanted to get a master's and become an architect as quickly as possible. So I applied to grad school in my senior year, and then immediately after graduating undergrad, I went to Harvard to study architecture and become an architect. And I think that architecture, unlike graphic design, is not about communicating a direct message. It operates rather like the soundtrack in a movie, where you sometimes don't realize it, but it affects the way you feel and the way you act and interact with others. Sometimes it has to do with making something very simple and contemporary and creating more spaces that are more inclusive, that remove hierarchy and introduce more of a horizontal way of interacting with others in the same space. Some of the most creative work happens when you address problems you didn't even know exist in ways that you couldn't imagine, you know, the different collaborations, different ways of articulating or describing a problem, and then different ways of thinking about those solutions. You know, I think about the war in Syria. Growing up, I spent like 2 or 3 years there going to school. Or climate change, or the way that people are represented in visual culture. That's the one that we have the power to change a little bit more than some of the others. It's important to fail in order to discover. So the way you describe your failure, the way you write about it, or think about it, or draw about it, is hugely important because it can lead you down a path of further failure, or it can lead you towards a path of maybe doing something differently next time. So I really believe in writing your own story of how you want to think about failure. For somebody who wants to pursue a career as an architect, I will say what my first studio instructor told me: you're the one who decides what you make of it. I will say though that architecture is also a very long-term profession. There's a lot of patience required, and then the collaborative aspect is also very important for architecture. And I think that different people have different ways of being architecture, so you just have to be good at it, and you have to really love it. That's architecture.